Hello and welcome back to part 3. This is the water challenge. And I feel like I got a good feeling about this one. Yeah, I feel like I can make this work. Let's just get right into it. I don't think I didn't have a hiatus, so I think I could just jump into it. This is my setup. So generally speaking, you know, bubbles because I got it's a little easier to control, and entangling vines because generally really strong, and entangle blast because I think it's the best water signature. No idea the attack with vice go through walls? That's a nice bonus. Oof, this guy. Okay. I need to find better water arcana. Oh wait, no, that's not. Ooh, that's cool. I hope I get something nice. Vampire's eyeglasses already. Shame I don't get any water arcana, but let's see what I can do around that. So the water fire does increase water damage, but I don't feel okay with using it that much. Good chance. Already. Okay. I'm glad I can get the vampire's eyeglasses so quickly. I wonder what the red room is then. Ow. Oh, come on. I can do better than that. You. You know what? Fuck it. I will use just for this one, cuz I need the damage. I wonder if that actually works that way. Okay, I think I saw it happen, but I wonder if Tidal Blast will push entangling vines towards enemies. If it does, that would be really, really good. It does! Time to take a box. Ooh, baby! If I get that boost, that vampire's eyeglass is gonna it's gonna come in real clutch. Seekers. A vampire cookbook that could actually work really well. Journal of Midas. I need to keep that. So, if I had to trade one, I could. Let's see. So I have two unenhanced arcana. On the off chance, so not very off chance, but if I go through with a sign that asks me to trade an arcana, what are the chances that they will throw away my entangling vines? Well, kind of high actually. I mean creeping tendrils. Yeah, I forgot the name of it. Creeping Tendrils. So... Yeah, there she is. Yeah, there we go. Alright. Let's hope Virtuoso Iris can give me something useful so I can have a free trade. Because I did not feel comfortable giving Dr. Song anything. What's this? Not bad. Absorption coil? Whatever, take any damage. It's a basic, kind of useless, not gonna help me. Oh. Let's try to finish everything first before I make any hasty decisions. I got the Journal of Midas, meaning if I can not take damage, I can get a lot of extra gold. These guys do not- oh, I really took damage. Fine, I'll create it. Okay, so this is what I'm gonna do. So that way, it's the only unenhanced one. Elixir might. This is really strong. Very strong. Oh yeah, the shield. One, two, three. What? Already? Oh, nice. Obviously, I'm not taking that. It's actually gonna be the hardest part, I think. Well, actually no. This is still gonna be a bitch. Is it gonna be a pain to fight? What? So these... If I could... That could actually go really well, but... I think these are kinda, especially with like Cardis Prime, be really helpful and no! You're so nice today. Okay, so I'll give you this. I like these a little too much. hold on to it. Crimea, the collector. I actually kind of came in clutch this time. Oh man, I love creeping tendrils. I see what I missed, but you know. Which relic guy? I forgot his name. Is your offer? I take damage? Kind of counterintuitive. Alright, I made up my mind. I didn't even use my ult! How did I get the quest speed down? I love this. You spoil me, game. You spoil me. As much as I like Pathfinder's map, I think I want to focus on upgrading my Arcana more. And by that I mean immediately. Cloud Kick is nice, but it's counterintuitive because my whole MO is now trying to avoid getting hit and charging up the takeout box as quickly as possible. Game, you did not have to, but I'll take it.
Yes!
What you got, Iris? Nothing useful, got it. Wrong one. I should have sold the Vampire's Cookbook now that I think about it. Yeah. Perfect. One. Ew. This one sucks. I don't even need the ward of the. I don't even need the ward anymore. This thing is just doing all this. Is just doing all of the damage I need. So fun fact, Counterspell is actually one of my favorite arcanas in the game, just because I tend to use it with my favorite build. Oh my. Thank you. Yeah, sure. I heal it all back anyway. For a tiny crocodile heart, and look at my goal is 666 and 999. What a wonderful number. Wait a second. That could actually really work. More crits, more heal. Finally. I don't need crit damage anymore. Or do I? Like, do I really though? I do have dice with a nemesis. Think about it. This was not originally meant to be a crit build, but these things happen. Honestly, yeah. Screw defense! I'm speeding into fights, baby! Oh, I took some damage. How sad. This is fun. That was great. My setup is kind of perfect. I'm ready for you. What? I even crit healed there? Nice catch. I missed again. From struggling so hard to get this right in the last run to sweeping through the whole run so easily this time. So far, of all the challenges, this is the luckiest I've ever gotten. And this is, and last time I did this, I had a run where I had a double trouble with evading Zephyr, so, hey! Let's hope this gets luckier! Well, that was fun. And I hope I can make this work again. This is one hell of a way to end this runoff, isn't it? Alright then. Let's make this work next. Let's make the next lightning run work well. And I'll look forward to it. Because I like a lot of lightning arcanas. See ya!